Before we go back to your concert in London, I have some few questions about this new album, Perfect Symmetry. In fact, I have to be honest with you, I have the feeling that this album is really different from the two first, and actually that's, I think, the less symmetry of all. I mean, it's maybe the most, I don't know, you dared a lot of stuff, you make a lot of change in the voice, in the chords, in the rhythm and everything. So why calling it symmetry, perfect symmetry?
I think what we were trying to talk about was that a lot of, one of the themes on the record is that people really could be better than they are. You know, not in a very sympathetic way, but humanity could really achieve so much more than we actually do. And so I guess in a way, Perfect Symmetry is trying to aim for that. You know, for achieving, you know, a much better world in which we live. But, you know, it's difficult to sum up a record in one phrase, but I think that reflects what we were trying to get to.
But do you agree with my vision of musically have something completely different from the past and less, how can I say that, you know, less straight, more daring?
Yeah, well, our favourite bands and favourite solo artists have always been people that are about reinvention and changing themselves and changing people's expectations and perceptions of who they are. You know, whether it's David Bowie or Radiohead or U2, or they're all bands or people who have constantly changed. And so we look up to that and we feel that's the way we approach our own music. And we always want to try out new things and experiment. And this album, you know, we just did that. We really let go, and you know, we didn't think to ourselves, we are keen, we must be a certain way. We just thought we can do anything that we like and have fun doing it.
Okay, so you know what you do? You have to buy this Perfect Symmetry from Keen. So you are really close to be on stage here in Antwerp.
Yeah.
How do you prepare yourself for a concert like that? Right now you seem completely cool, but you're going to play in front of a crowd in a few minutes, huh?
You know, we warm up, you know. We all sing on stage now, and so I guess, you know, just kind of go through a few songs, and I don't know, we've played quite a lot of gigs, so I don't want to say that we get a lot of adrenaline, and it is still a really, really exciting thing to do, but you know, I think, you know, we're not quite as nervous as we used to be. The first gigs we did, we were so nervous, we'd have so much adrenaline that you know, we'd play seven songs and normally they'd take, you know, 40 minutes, and we'd play them and we'd play them so fast they'd only take 30 minutes, you know, because we were so full of adrenaline.
Okay, so let's go back to your concert in London where you were completely, well, nervous, we can say that?
I think we were quite, no, that we'd, I can't remember which night it is. We did three nights, I think, at Brixton. So it was the third night we were less nervous. But it was the first night we were terrified.
Yeah, we're always more nervous when there are TV cameras around though.
Me too. Voilà qui clôture notre live de Keen à Londres, mais bon, pas notre interview, on est toujours avec eux. So guys, few more questions before you go, because I know that you have some work to do. It's not the first time that you played in Belgium, actually. Do you like Belgium? Do you like our country to play gigs?
We absolutely love it, yeah. I think the highlight of our festival season, was it last year? Yeah, it was last year. Was it the year before? It was the year before. I can never remember. No, it was last year. It was 2007, yeah. We was playing at Vector, and we were part of the most incredible...
Oh, yeah. That
was, yeah, it was in Rockwater that you played in 2007.
Yeah. It was an incredible lineup. I mean...
I think it was the best festival lineup we've ever been a part of. And frankly, I think... who was it? It was like Amy Winehouse, Snow Patrol, The Killers...
Razorlight. The Chemical Brothers...
Yeah, that's definitely a good lineup.
It was just like this continuous line of like lots of really exciting, you know, bands and artists. Well, actually, most of those from Britain. And we felt really excited to be a part of that. And the crowd was just absolutely amazing. People just giving everything. And I think it was, you know, we've talked about it amongst ourselves, and we could definitely consider it to be our favourite ever festival performance. And everything's so well organised in Belgium as well, so like, you know, everything works backstage and everything's kind of clean and friendly and happy, you know, which is not what you get in many other parts of the world. So yeah, we love it,
especially in England.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's amazing. I remember getting there, we were in a little car on the way there, and there were just all these people cycling to the festival, and you get there and there are all these bikes just sort of parked up, and you just think, why isn't England like this? You know, it's, yeah, it's a great country. And the, yeah, Perth is definitely, I think that is our favourite. I think we played better there than we've ever played at a festival anywhere else.
Well, if I can tell you a secret, I think that a lot of Belgian bands will kill to play in England. So I think that it's like of a balance somewhere.
Yeah. It's like a cultural exchange. We should have more swaps.
And are you planning to tour everywhere, to go around the world now?
Yeah, we are. We're here, obviously, and going around mainland Europe over the next few weeks. And then we're probably going off to America for a short while. And then we're going to a big UK arena tour next year. And then South America, America.
Maybe Australia. And we've never been to New Zealand to play, and hopefully we're going there too. So maybe Japan as well. And yeah, who knows? It's great, you know. It's kind of exciting to sit back, and then your manager comes along and says, I think we should go to New Zealand. And we're like, cool.
Well, good luck with all that. And before I let you go, just one last question. At the end of the show, we always show a bonus track. You can choose it. So which song would you like to hear and which video clip would you like to see?
Well, interesting enough, we're just about to release our next single off our new record, which is called Perfect Symmetry. And we made the video with a guy called Grant G, who directed a great film about Radiohead called Meeting People Is Easy, which kind of followed them on tour back in 97, I think.
I think in 96. I've seen
it. Yeah. Okay. And yeah, he directed our new video that we're doing, and he also directed the video that we'd like to watch now, which is No Surprises by Radiohead.
Good choice. Je rappelle que si vous voulez revoir l'entièreté de cette émission, rien de plus facile, surfez sur le www.plugrtl.be/simpler. Vous pouvez aussi nous écrire, franchement, n'hésitez pas. Et avant de partir, des petits cadeaux, des t-shirts Kid, mais aussi leur tout dernier album sont à remporter au 35-31. Pour ce faire, rien de plus facile, vous envoyez un message en indiquant plug espace Kid, suivi de vos coordonnées complètes, donc le numéro 35-31. Voilà, avant de partir, on va quand même pas partir comme des voleurs, je vous propose de découvrir quelques images de Kid ici à la Lotto Arena d'Anvers. À la semaine prochaine.